topic of discussion here is about reheat factor. Actually, we are working on steam turbine power plant, and in the steam turbine power plant, we know that the reality would have expansion in the enthalpy, expansion in the turbine, but the end or exhaust of the turbine would have temperature more than the ideal temperature. So there is some heat, some energy which is residue in the turbine exhaust, which has not got converted into work. That residue energy, that energy difference between the ideal exhaust and the real exhaust is called as reheat, and we are going to use this reheat concept to get some more expressions which are used for the getting idea or performance of the turbine. So we will first understand what do we mean by reheat. In the TS diagram, we can better understand that this is turbine, and then in this turbine we know that this is expansion from the state or entry to the turbine to the state at the exhaust to the turbine. Now in this, in reality, this would follow this line. Now if we are here, then what would the fact is, the constant pressure line is like this. Though, so this is the, suppose S dash as ideal exhaust, but this is S which is real exhaust. So the difference in enthalpy in these two states, so H S minus H S dash is called as reheat, So this is the enthalpy which is there in the flow which has not got converted into work. So if A is the state at the inlet, then H A minus H S is turbine work, but H A minus H S dash is turbine work in ideal state, W T dash. So in both the cases, if we consider, then H S minus H S dash is called as reheat. There is one more fact which we should understand for reheat. So there is this as one pressure line. So the constant pressure lines diverge from each other at higher entropy side. So if we take the pressure ratio same, then this line is at more diverged, this line is less diverged. So the point S would be more farther and amount of reheat would be higher. So knowing this, we should consider a factor, reheat factor, also called as RF. Let us draw a TS diagram for better understanding where we are expressing the turbine work in multiple pressures. So this is one, this is other, this is third, and this is fourth. So this we will take like this, this is state 1, and then this is state 2S, or we will say it as 2 dash. So the corresponding state is 2, corresponding real state is 2. But if we would have expanded from 2 to 3, then we would have come over here. So this we will represent here as 3 dash, and here we would represent as 3 double dash, and from 3 to 4, but reality would be here as 3. So we would have further 0.4 here and 0.4 dash here, sorry, 0.4 double dash here and 4 here. So the line which is joining 1, 2, 3, 4 is the real line, also called as condition line. And here we can say this point as 4 dash. So this is the expansion, ideal expansion of the steam from state 1 to 4 dash, and if we would decompose it into 3 pressure ratios, one is A, B and C. So if we would have expanded from for this 1 to 2, then we would have got 2 dash as ideal and 2 as real and then if we would have expanded from 2 to 3, then 3 double dash would have been ideal and 4 double dash practically would be ideal for third case. Then reheat factor would be defined as the summation of enthalpies of small vertical lines divided by the big vertical line, which is isentropic. So we will say that this is H1 minus H2 dash. So this is small vertical line plus the next vertical line, which is H2 minus H3 double dash plus H3 minus H4 double dash divided by H1 minus H4 dash. This is ideal enthalpy drop if we consider complete all stages, and this is enthalpy drop in ideal case in each stage. So this is the ratio which we are calling it as reheat factor. Now we will say that there is some stage efficiency and each stage has its efficiency. So knowing that, we know stage efficiency is turbine efficiency for that stage. So in one stage number 1, we have real enthalpy drop is H1 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H2 dash. Similarly, stage efficiency is equal to H2 minus H3 divided by H2 minus H3 double dash. So similarly, stage efficiency is equal to H3 minus H4 divided by H3 minus H4 double dash. So we can express H1 minus H2 is equal to H1 minus H2 dash is equal to H1 minus H2 divided by stage efficiency. Similarly, H2 minus H3 double dash is equal to H2 minus H3 divided by stage efficiency, and H3 minus H4 double dash is equal to H3 minus H4 divided by stage efficiency. So we can write down reheat factor is equal to H1 minus H2 divided by stage efficiency plus H2 minus H3 divided by stage efficiency plus H3 minus H4 divided by stage efficiency divided by H1 minus H4 dash. Here our assumption is all stages have same stage efficiency. So we get reheat factor as 1 upon stage efficiency, and we get H1 minus H2 plus H2 minus H3 plus H3 minus H4. So this H2, H2 and H3, H3 would cancel and we get H1 minus H4. So H1 is the inlet enthalpy for the turbine, H4 is outlet enthalpy for the turbine divided by H1 minus H4 dash. So we can write down here that H1, but we know one thing, that H1 minus H4 divided by H1 minus H4 dash is turbine efficiency, or also called as internal efficiency. So we know now RF is equal to 1 upon stage efficiency into internal efficiency, and hence internal efficiency is equal to RF into stage efficiency. So since RF is more than 1, if stage efficiency is known, then we can find out internal efficiency or turbine efficiency, and it leaves to us, and it is understood to us from here that since RF is more than 1, we will have internal efficiency more than stage efficiency. So this is how we can make use of the fact that there is a reheat factor, and that can be used for understanding the turbine better from the stage to the complete integration of all stages. Thank you.